Addressing the media yesterday at the National Unity Platform offices in Kamoja, the party leadership revealed that dozens of her members and supporters were mysteriously missing, an indication that they had been abducted by security agencies. These went ahead to explain that some of her colleagues had been detained without charge, hence pointing out witch hunt from the ruling government.
The abductions that are still going on in this country. Over the weekend, some people were taken. You saw our coordinators in Busoga, the family members who were picked up and taken. Now the excuse is ADF. You know, our people being hounded left, right, and center. Many of our people have had to run out of the country. So those are the challenges we are talking about.
Yeah, we have many of our people that are still in jail, over flimsy, in some cases, non-existent cases. You know, trumped up charges and all of that. It is our duty as leaders, as members of NUP, as Ugandans, to fight for the freedoms of these people. All right? Because you see, today it is them, tomorrow it is any of us.
Responding to them today, the Uganda Human Rights Commission rubbished the claims, saying the commission had in November last year wrote to the NUP requesting for information on persons they alleged to be missing. A list of only 25 people was availed to the commission.
Photographs of the missing persons and the details of their national identification numbers. The following day, 29th November 2022, the National Unity Platform responded to my request and provided particulars of 25 people, but not the thousands they have been talking about, who they said were missing. These particulars included their photographs, their dates when they are said to have gone missing, and the contacts of their next of kin.
Wangadia further explains that out of the total number presented, investigations established that 7 were released in December and have since reunited with their families. Among the 7, 3 were charged with murder, while 4 others were arraigned and are battling charges related to malicious damage to property.
We have established that out of the 25 persons provided, 7 were arrested but released in December last year and have since reunited with their families. The 7 people I'm talking about include Kavuma, Jamshid, Sonko, Haruna, Badru, Mtale Charles, Abdu Bayani Babu, Godfrey Chirumira Mavin, Ahumza Patrick, and Moleme Stephen. Out of the 7 people, 3 were charged with murder.
In March 2021, a list of over 400 allegedly missing persons was presented to Parliament. NUP went ahead to file a petition in the International Criminal Court asking it to compel the Ugandan government to produce the people allegedly abducted by the security agencies. After fruitless efforts, the NUP is now considering petitioning the African Commission on Human Rights as well as the East African Court on the same matter. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.